Battlefield 2042 is here, and although all of us know what to do in a Battlefield game, there is some stuff you may not know about this specific one. Hi folks, it's Falcon, and today on Game Ranks, 10 things Battlefield 2042 doesn't tell you. Starting off with number 10, you can do some crazy stuff with the wingsuit. The wingsuit, which you can use if you select the special Sundance, is fun to just screw around with, but you might not realize how effective it can be. On top of being great for getting around the map quickly, there's a lot of fun stuff you can do with a wingsuit, and in the proper hands, you can do some pretty impressive stunts. Here's a few things about it you might not realize. You don't actually need to get very high up to start gliding with a wingsuit. It has to be higher than something you can vault on top of, but only just barely. So anything where you have to climb up just a little bit more in order to get on top of it, like shipping containers or these trucks, these are things you can start gliding from. Anything lower than that, it's less likely to work, but as long as the ground is flat, you can cross a pretty huge distance pretty quickly by gliding, but at a certain point it does start to slow down considerably. The trick to avoid that is to chain together glides. So if you want to get around really fast, continuously glide to ledges. Like on Hourglass, there are these trucks everywhere. You use them to chain together multiple glides and you'll get around super fast. And because you can cancel a glide and start one up again, there's also potential for some pretty cool tricks. I'm not really good enough to pull this sort of thing off, but one fairly easy trick you can do is equip some C5 and then glide to a tank. And if you come at them from behind, there's a good chance they won't see you coming. Plant the C4, glide off, done. It's a great way to take out enemy vehicles, which is good because vehicles are by far the biggest threat in Battlefield 2042. And number 9, the best guns currently, with only 22 available at launch. And that's not a huge amount of guns, so it's no surprise people quickly found favorites. Two guns in particular sort of stand above all the others, the PP29, also known as the Bison, and the SVK. The PP29, which I enjoy continuously saying, PP, which unlocks at rank 18, is an SMG with a large magazine, a high rate of fire, and it's also really accurate, even at pretty long ranges. For whatever reason, it seems to be more accurate than any of the rifles available at that level, and combine that with its high damage because of its fire rate, and you have a gun that's almost definitely gonna get nerfed at some point. It's clearly the best choice for a machine gun right now. Like, no other full auto comes even close to this. It's just way better. The other gun, the SVK, is more of your traditionally powerful battlefield weapon. It's DMR. It's a powerful rifle that can take down most enemies with two body shots. It's extremely accurate and it's easy to use with a fast rate of fire. Sniping is and always will be strong in Battlefield games, and if you want to snipe, this is probably the best thing to use. It's another gun that's probably gonna be nerfed at some point, but who really knows, because I wouldn't really call it as ridiculous as the PP, but who really knows. Hopefully DICE will just fix how weak and inaccurate the other rifles are right now, and that'll put everyone on a more even playing field. But at the moment, there's really no reason not to use the PP29 or the SVK. They're just better than most of the other weapons in the game right now. At number 8 is the C5 drone trick. Tanks are beastly in this game. Taking one out normally requires multiple people with rocket launchers to really damage them, but there's a fun trick you can use to blow up tanks that are just camping a ridge or something. All you need is a drone recon specialist and some C5. The concept's simple. Summon a drone, put some C5 on it, fly the drone to the tank, and detonate it. You'd think the tanks would be on the lookout for these things, but drones can actually be tough to see at times, let alone shoot down, so a lot of players just totally ignore them. As long as you got a decent hiding place that's far enough away from the front lines, you should be safe, and with a little practice, you'll be destroying tanks in no time. The trick is really one of the best ways to take out these vehicles. It's safe, the drones are hard to hit, and C5 does way more damage to tanks than pretty much anything else early on. I'm sure once people start seeing this happen more, they'll actually start shooting at drones once in a while, but right now, tanks might as well be free kills if you're playing as Casper. At number 7, the robot dog is actually the best way to combat enemy drones. The drones deployed by the specialist Casper can be especially annoying to deal with. Just hitting these things, like I said in the previous point, is a pain in the ass. They're small targets, they can buzz around all over the place. Trying to shoot them down can be a frustrating waste of time, but there's actually an easier way. Just call in a robot dog. These things are great for giving you a little bit of cover, they absorb a surprising amount of damage, and they can easily take out those annoying little drones. Yes, they're mostly just just around for recon, but if the enemy knows where you are, then it becomes a lot easier for them to kill you. Not a lot of players focus on taking these things out, even though they really should be a big priority, and a part of that's probably how hard they actually are to hit. But if you want to deal with them without having to do too much, call in a robot dog, because they will destroy drones for you. At number 6, proximity sensors are fantastic for racking up experience. If you want to farm experience in this game, solo will only get you so far. At the moment, there is a cap on the amount of experience you can earn from playing solo, and it's not a whole lot. Weapon experience is a little more generous. You can unlock at least a few weapon attachments just by starting a solo game and killing bots, but eventually you will hit a wall there as well. If you want to generate a lot of experience quick when playing Battlefield multiplayer, here is a simple solution. Just equip the proximity sensor grenade. This thing does exactly what you think it would. It detects enemies in a wide area when you throw it. That kind of situational awareness is good on its own, but when you combine it with the recon experience you get, it's great. To really rack up a lot of experience, play something like Breakthrough, where everybody will be concentrated on a single objective, and throw a grenade at a high traffic area. And because death comes so quickly in modes like this, there's really no reason for you not to throw them out all the time. Restarting just means you get a grenade refill, so if there's ever a free moment, just throw out a proximity grenade. Experience really starts to slow down around the time you unlock the proximity sensor at rank 22, so if you want to keep gaining ranks quick, this seems to be the best thing to use. And number 5, you can deploy vehicles on top of skyscrapers. It wouldn't be Battlefield without some almost game-breaking strategies, but this is one of the most basic. Any mission where there's a control point on top of a building, like, let's say, Kaleidoscope, you can just drop a vehicle on the roof and you're pretty much set. The Wildcat is your best defensive option. It's great for taking out helicopters, and its machine guns shred everyone who tries to take the elevator. There's a few strategies to counter rooftop vehicles, but for the moment, most players don't know what to do about it, so you can rack up like a ridiculous amount of kills if you put it in the right spot. To get the most out of the Wildcat, make sure you got the homing rockets unlocked. Combine that with the main cannon, you can pretty much kill anything, even the surprisingly tough hovercrafts. The strategy here is simple as it gets. Just call a Wildcat on a rooftop when you get the chance, and in all honesty, it doesn't even have to be a point you have to defend. If you're on a roof, it's great. As long as there's stuff around to kill, it works. And number 4, many vehicle attachments are straight up upgrades. Along with being able to unlock attachments for your weapons, you can also unlock attachments for vehicles in this game, and many of them are just straight up better than what you start out with. Like the Jeep's 30mm or 50mm cannon, they both just are all around better than the starting machine guns, so having them unlocked makes your life way easier. Even basic stuff like systems automatically repairing themselves are locked at first, so getting some of this stuff should be a priority. The only way to unlock stuff for your vehicles is to get kills, which can be annoying when you're playing online, but with Battlefield 2042, they made it so you can easily get a weapon with vehicle experience, even if you're playing against bots. That's really the fastest way you can unlock stuff for your vehicles. Just load up a single player breakthrough game and mow down as many brain dead AI enemies as you can. Right now, there is a limit to the amount of XP you can earn against bots, so you can only unlock so much before you're forced to do it in multiplayer, but it's still a useful trick to quickly unlock a few key upgrades for a vehicle to give yourself a more of like a fighting chance when you go online. And number 3, if you're playing on console, turn off crossplay. Unless a game has some really aggressive auto-aim, players using a keyboard and a mouse are always going to have an advantage over players using a controller. That's just part of playing an FPS online. But it feels way worse in Battlefield 2042, and it's for one very big reason. At least currently, the auto-aim for controllers feels almost non-existent. It's another one of the many things in this game that DICE will most likely eventually fix, I'm sure, but for now, it makes sense to turn off crossplay and save yourself some headaches. On PlayStation consoles, it's actually really easy to do. You can do it from the options menu in the game itself, but for whatever reason, it's pretty well hidden on the Xbox, and the instructions you get for Xbox consoles isn't really good enough. So here's how to actually turn it off on Xbox. You go to Xbox Settings, Account, Privacy, Online Settings, Xbox Privacy, then View Details and Customize, then Communication, and finally Multiplayer. It's like 6 menus deep. It's like they're almost intentionally hiding it or whatever. Of course, you can always connect a keyboard and a mouse to your consoles. Like, that's a good option, actually. But if you want to use a controller and you're on console, it's not a bad idea to turn off crossplay. It'll save some frustration. And number two, an easy way to grind for credits is in Hazard Zone, which is basically Escape from Tarkov combined with Battlefield. It's PvPvE experience where you run around a map, collecting data drives while dealing with AI who guards certain areas and other teams of players who also want to collect more drives than you. To add some risk and reward to the whole thing, there's a credit system where you spend money before the match to purchase more powerful weapons and equipment, but once you spend those credits, they're gone, and if a game doesn't go well, you lost credits rather than gain them. So just starting out, it makes it hard to focus on getting a supply of credits, so you're not going to the game with basic weapons and items. The easiest way to build up credits is fairly simple. On the loadout screen, select Negotiated Bounty, Tactical Upgrade. It makes you earn 50% more credits when you kill occupying forces, aka bots. Now just focus on killing AI enemies. Getting data drives is also important, of course, but if you lose, then you get nothing. Whereas if you kill a lot of AI with this tactical equip, you'll get a lot of credits at the end of the game one way or the other. So if you just focus on doing this for a little while, you can build up a decent amount of credits so you can start going on to teams with more of a fighting chance. Pulling this off requires a team that can communicate. Trying to do this sort of thing in public games probably isn't going to work very well, but Hazard Zone basically requires teamwork as is. It's not the best game to just pick up and play anyway, so you're going to want a team you can talk to if you want a chance of actually winning. And finally, at number one, the hovercraft is a beast. If you've spent any time playing this game, you probably know it already. The hovercraft's crazy good. You'd think a transport vehicle would be, like, pretty weak, but no, this thing basically shrugs off small arms fire like nothing, and can take a surprising amount of punishment from any anti-armor weapon. In the right hands, the hovercraft can sneak behind enemy lines and get tons of kills. If you're playing this game and haven't messed around with vehicles or just getting frustrated because you're not getting a lot of kills, just spawn into a hovercraft and suddenly you will be a killing machine. The other thing that makes this vehicle so good is how it can get to places that it should not. Like, you can wreak havoc inside a building with a control point or catch people by surprise by traveling up a vertical wall. Like, at the moment, yes, you can do that. I don't know how long it will last. It's one part that I expect DICE to probably fix in the future. But even if they nerf this thing into oblivion, it's still a great flanking tool to get behind enemy lines. Right now, if you want to get a lot of easy kills in Battlefield, this is the vehicle to use. That's all for today. Leave us a comment, let us know what you think. If you like this video, click like. If you're not subscribed, now's a great time to do so. We upload brand new videos every day of the week. Best way to see them first is, of course, a subscription, so click subscribe. Don't forget to enable all notifications, and as always, I thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Falcon. You can follow me on Twitter, Falcon the Hero. We'll see you next time, right here on GameRanks.